Hi, I'm Debbie with ServiceStar, and today we're going to talk about what to include in a proper Phoenix rental agreement. A lease agreement is a binding contract that you'll sign with your tenants at the beginning of the tenancy. This lease will be the first place you will turn if there are any disputes, disagreements, or conflicts during the lease period. So you'll need to make sure it's legally binding and protective of your rights and your property. If you're not working with a professional Phoenix property management company, we recommend that you contact an attorney before you draft and sign a lease. There are several important elements that absolutely must be included. Use an Arizona lease. For starters, make sure you're using a lease that is valid and enforceable in Arizona. It should reference laws and requirements that are specific to the state. A lot of landlords make the mistake of downloading a lease template or using a sample that is not state specific. You want to make sure that your lease will hold up in Arizona courtrooms if necessary. Next, make sure the lease is in writing. It's virtually impossible to enforce a verbal lease, and without a written lease, you cannot hold your tenants accountable even for basic things like rent payments. Establish the lease term. Your lease agreement must state when the tenancy begins and when it ends, and make sure that your lease covers at least 1 year. There are different laws and requirements for shorter lease periods, and the standard lease is 12 months. You'll also want to stipulate what happens at the end of a lease term. Identify tenants, occupants, and property. The lease must identify the property that's being rented. Please provide the address and a brief description, such as single-family home or unit in a condo community. Make sure you include the name and contact information as well as the tenants. Every adult occupant age 18 and older should be included in the lease. Minor children should also be listed, and you'll also want to mention the breeds, names, and ages of any of the pets as well. Include rental amounts and conditions. Include the security deposit amount that was collected. In Arizona, you cannot take more than the equivalent of 1.5 months rent for deposit. Indicate where it will be held and how it will be returned. Rules, restrictions, and requirements. The lease agreement is a good place to list all the things that tenants are not permitted to do at the property. It is your opportunity to protect yourself from liability and property damage by prohibiting things like smoking, drugs, trampolines, kiddie pools, unauthorized tenants and pets, altering the property without permission. Be sure the lease agreement includes information on how much notice is required before a tenant moves out, whether guests are allowed overnight, and if renter's insurance is required. You'll also need to include information about tenants compliant with HOA rules, if that applies. There are a lot of legal considerations and consequences that come with the lease agreement, which is why we strongly recommend that you work with an attorney or a Phoenix property management company before you sign your lease with your tenants. Contact us at ServiceStar Realty if you'd like to see the type of lease we use or to further talk with us about what should be included in your lease.